Hello, I'm Amit Nerurkar, and today we'll be focusing on the topic of network topologies. So network topology actually defines the architecture of the network. So there are basic various network topologies that we would be understanding. The first type of topology is known as a bus topology. So if you see the architecture of the bus topology, you can understand all of the devices are connected in a serial fashion, one after the other. And now the last device would be logically connected to the first device. So sometimes this bus topology is also known as logical ring. So if, for example, if server wants to send any data for this particular laptop, it would be sending in this particular channel. But here there is a higher probability of the collision issue, because if what if two, three devices start communicating at the same time? So to handle that, we will consider a solution like use of token. A device having the token would be given a permission to send the data. So the token will keep circulating in the network. Sometimes that architecture is also known as token bus. Now here there is one more issue. Even though it is very simple to implement, single break in a cable will bring the entire network down. The next connection, next approach is known as next topology, is ring topology, where the first device is connected to second, second to third, third to last, last back to first. So in case of bus topology, we were using the term that it is also known as logical ring. This is an example of a physical ring. Now even here, if there is a single break in the cable, the issue would be the entire network would be down. Again, in the ring topology, the connection is always unidirectional. So you can see there are two rings implemented, one from left to right direction and one from right to left direction, because a ring is a unidirectional topology. And even here, if multiple nodes start sending data, there is an issue of collision. So to handle that, again we can go for a token ring approach. A device having the token can send the data, and the token will keep circulating in the network. Every topology will have a single token, so that at a time only one device can send the data, which can avoid the issue of collision. The next topology is known as star topology, where every device is connected to a central device known as hub. So a hub, or maybe you can use a networking component known as star. So all of these devices would be communicating through hub. So if this device wants to communicate, send data to particular device, for example this device, the packet will come from this device, it will go to hub, from hub it would be delivered to this particular device. The only issue over here is single point of failure. If hub is down, the entire network will be down. Finally, the most reliable form of communication, the most reliable form of topology, is known as mesh topology, where every device is connected to every other device. So if any of the link breaks, there should not be an issue, because the device would be connected to that particular device via other device. And here the only thing is, it is very costly, because it requires total n into n minus 1 number of divided by 2 number of links. So overall it is a very costly approach, but then it is a very reliable approach. So these were the four basic topologies, the basic four architectures used over the network. So these topologies further are used for building up the network architecture. So for further more updates on concepts videos of computer network, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is Amit Nerurkar signing off. Thank you.